it's a lot more aggressive, you know, and it's more of a mental game, you know, because anybody can do what I do. It's not like I have a special body that does this stuff. Actually, I mean, if I could use someone else's body, I probably could do a lot more stuff, you know, because they're probably in better shape than mine, you know. But you know, it's just this part that kind of that gets you through with ramps and stuff. I think a good way to explain it is, whenever you're riding, you can't talk to fear, you can't see fear, you know. Otherwise, you're gonna kind of compromise on some of your actions, and which could make you screw up and get hurt. So when the riders are up on top of the ramp, they have no fear. You're focused and you're not thinking about fear, you know. So your bike, after a while, becomes just an extension of your body. But it's a really cool thing to be able to just block out all fear and just do work off your feelings. And it's just kind of a pure soul thing, you know. You're just working off what your soul is telling you, you know.
Matt's riding has become so spectacular that nowadays he takes the show on the road to spread the word.
We travel around doing shows and stuff with it, and that's basically it. We just go to different fairs and try to recruit the kids to start riding, you know. Ceiling, you know, and so it's not real sturdy, I guess, and whenever the wind blows, it creaks in.
When he's home, Matt's like a crazy scientist in his laboratory, always trying to put new and radical theories to the test.
Instead of working in the limits, working with the limits, you know, that's kind of the fun part of it, not having any rules and just trying to you know, give that little extra, you know, when you're pushing the limits and stuff, of course you're gonna mess up sometimes, and you're gonna have to do the trial and error thing, you know. You just have to learn. I'm in it for the long run, and I want to experience all the pleasures this has to give me, you know. So I'm of course gonna accept all the pain that's gonna come along with it.
Okay, cool.
That's one rider who could never be accused of not going for his tricks, which means that when it does go wrong, he slams hard. When you get to this level in the sport, slamming becomes as much a part of it as pulling off the trick. And so by now, Matt knows as much about pain and injuries as he does about backflips.
Okay, Matt, tell us about this place. Where are we?
This is at my mechanic shop. It's kind of body mechanics. I have to go put myself in the shop every once in a while. And this is the guy that fixes me all up. Cracked tibia, crank stab leg, countless concussions, 6 broken ankles. I broke my wrist, 10 screws and a plate put in my ankle. A reconstructed shoulder surgery. So I'm doing therapy right now, just trying to get my shoulder all fixed up and stuff. So.
Describe Matt as an absolute orthopedic surgeon's dream and a father's nightmare.
3 broken toes, I had orthopedic knee surgery, and then I had a bruised kidney. I broke my jaw disc one time.
And I keep putting him back together as long as he wants to keep riding. It's not something I enjoy.
4 fractured teeth, a tumor removed from my leg, a lot of stitches. I got hit by a car 4 times.
If Matt was my son, I'd have a different opinion, most likely.
Lose bone fragments in my left elbow. I stubbed my pinky toe once, and I broke both my thumbs and broken foot metacarpals.
We also hope that by the time he reaches the ripe old age of 30, he can get out of bed in the morning.
I strained my eyes reading in the dark, 3 broken collarbones. I got amnesia, I think. 2 broken ribs. That's about it. Me and Dennis, we're just kind of slowly working our way into knowing what pain is like now, so that when we're older, we'll be used to it and everything will be okay, you know?
If I can borrow it, we don't even need to watch it, so we can keep going. Just chow and then...
Okay.
I mean, you're sure it's it.